build up, and I will build it as in the days of old, that they may possess the remnant of Edom, those are the lead banker, and of all the heathen, which are called by my name, saith the Lord that doeth this. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of grapes with him that sows seed, and the mountains shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. And I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel, and they shall build a waste city and inhabit it, and they shall plant vineyards and drink wine there. They shall also make gardens and eat fruit vegetables.
Proverbs 14:32. The wicked is driven away in his wickedness, but the righteous have hope in death.
And the righteous have hope in his death. Yeah, so when we see a wicked person, I mean, obviously, you know, we be trying to get people to repent. You know, we teach them the truth. But once you know somebody's no damn good, bro, you just pray that the Lord destroy them. And then when that instruction comes, you rejoice. Throw a party, go buy a drink, get drunk, laugh at him. Like, hi, Most High got you. It's funny, it's hilarious. How many times we done laughed at someone's demise? I mean, we just laugh and laugh and laugh until we red in the face.
Psalm 37:13. The Lord shall laugh at him when he seeth that his day is coming.
Woo! That he can only make his home where ain't nothing to touch him. Only thing he in this world won't be fucked up is his health.
Because it is in the power of their hands. Yeah, it really goes into Esau too, but our people do the same shit. They first thing they do when they wake up in the morning, they plotting on how they gonna get somebody.
They take way more.
I've heard people sit there and tell me, like, yeah, this is how I do it. I sit and I watch you for, like, at least a week.
Yeah.
Then I get your schedule down.
He's patient.
Then once I get your schedule down, I just sneak on up in there, cut the wires. You know what I mean? They go into it. They're patient.
That's right. It's a nigga for you.
Oh, shit.
That's
like,
a spirit for you, though, because you're coming.
Yeah, I had this dude tell me. He's like, man, I just sit down in the bushes. I sit out in them bushes for hours if I got to.
Yeah.
I heard them, bro. They go in on it.
This is great. That's a blessing, man. We have to be home all the time, man. Instead of being forced out of the world, we have to do this and that. That's a blessing, man. You don't want, you want to be out doing something productive for making money. You know, you want to. But that's a blessing in the cover. That's a blessing in the cover.
I got this one right here. This is a quick precept. Psalms 119 and 115. Depart from me, ye evildoers, for I will keep the commandments of my power. You know what I mean? So you're still supposed to depart from these evildoers.
Right.
You ain't supposed to be making friends with them, hanging out with them, coming out with a new mixtape with them. Shit, not these days. You ain't gonna get none for the dime. They be smoking that crazy mutated weed now. I don't know what they call it. They call it, what do they call it? My brain. That word.
They see what it's doing.
They call it loud. That's what they call it. You got that loud pack.
By swearing and lying and killing and stealing and committing adultery.
Yeah, committing adultery. That's the heavy one right there. That's our people. They just a nation of adulterers, bro. That's one of the biggest problems our people have is adultery. There ain't no fucking families no more. No, a bunch of single independent women. And then they push it. They supposed to be proud of that. I'm a single mother. I'm a proud, hardworking single mother. And then they get praised for it, bro.
Independently strong.
And then that's the type of activity they encourage out here. You know what I mean? You're supposed to have a family. You're supposed to have a husband and a wife. And the wife is never, ever supposed to leave the husband. I know this is some groundbreaking fucking material and rules and shit. You know, people hear that shit, bro. Really? It sounds crazy. Yeah, a wife is never supposed to leave the husband. Ever, ever, ever. If she commits adultery, the Bible says the punishment for adultery is death. Both of them. And that way, you put sin away from Israel. And you go fucking up the order of things.
That's beautiful, man. That's beautiful. She married in a motherfucker.
I mean, it just makes sense. If that don't make sense, why you get mad at that's love, ain't it? Isn't it you staying with a wife and the wife staying with the husband, being loyal to each other and loving each other? Isn't that love? Isn't that love? Does anything get more love? They say we free take. There's no more love than that. That's like the ultimate love.
Who wants to go through your wife leaving shit?
Yeah, that's awful. You never get over it. You ever hear of being heartbroken? Hey, what did he call it? Yeah, what's that Led Zeppelin song, Heartbreaker? Alimony, paying your bills. That was my shit. Hey, these bitches, they some heartbreakers, bro. That's some cold-hearted bitches out here.
This is Leviticus 20 and 10. And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death.
Shall surely be put to death. They shall surely be put to death. So just because you think, oh, nobody saw me, or we in the modern era now. Okay, just keep thinking that we living in modern times. I mean, just believe what you want in your little pea brains, in your fucking penis-sized brain, you know what I mean? Because the Lord's going to get you, bro. We done see the end of adulterers time again. We see your end. Always catches up with you. You think you in the clear. The woman thinks she's in the clear. Not so fast. Now you get gasoline poured on you. Now you're on fire. How many times have you seen a bitch get caught on fire? Because adultery usually ends with death. Because the man will lose his mind over adultery. He'll do some crazy shit to get revenge.
Especially now, while now the spirit of the Lord is upon
the face. Yeah, the spirit.
That's the spirit is getting to people.
I seen a nigga in a video.
He was putting in work.
Damn. Like he ran into the front of the car. I guess it's the door for
him. Hey.
He shot him.
Hey man, that's it. There's no other spirit than the fury, the fury of jealousy. So how do you think the Most High feels when we committed spiritual adultery against him? What the fuck you think he's gonna do?
Furious rage.
It's rage. That's what's coming to this earth is rage. All right, go ahead. Sorry.
It's probably 6. But by means of a whorish woman, a man is brought to a piece of bread and adulterous. Life. Can the man take fire in his bosom and his clothes not be burned?
Now go ahead.
Can one go upon hot coals and his feet not be burned?
Ooh.
So he that goeth into his neighbor's wife, whosoever touches her, shall not be innocent. Men do not despise a thief. If he fails to satisfy his soul when he is hungry, if he be found, he shall restore sevenfold, and he shall give all his stuff to his house. But whoso committed adultery and woman lack of understanding, he that doeth it destroys his own soul.
Right, yeah, you dumb as hell, man. You gonna just
stupid. And you know it's wrong what you're doing, that's why you're sneaking people. You know? I hate a motherfucker like that in this
thing. Didn't you see the children all sad because their mom and dad's not together? You know what I mean? Go ahead.
A wound in a dishonor shall he get, and his reproach shall not be wiped away. Jealousy is the rage of a man, therefore he will not spare the time of the day of vengeance. He will not regard any ransom, neither will he.
They gonna be no negotiating with him on that day. If he seen you with his wife, he gonna kill you. That's all there is to it.
It's like the Most High tattooed with the gods.
Yep.
You know what I mean? The professor of other gods to the world, you know, it's the same shit, man. He won't let nobody get away with it. Dumbass.
Neither will he rest content, though thou givest me gifts.
Oh, I'll forget about it. Adultery, man, adultery is storming in peril. I mean, that fuel of jealousy is storming in peril.
Ain't no stopping it. Usually you ain't even thinking about jail or nothing. You ready to get in a shootout with the cops. Ready to get it on. That's the spirit of the Lord.
Ex-lovers and shit gonna come after them. They're ex-lovers, the ones they done fucked over in the past, you know? Niggas they done got locked up. And she thought, oh, he had never seen the light of day again. You know, he had never seen the light of day again. Here the motherfuckers, here Esau let him out after they gave him the chip. This is Jeremiah 4.
Hey, you know, adultery used to be a crime in America. Well, in the whole world.
Sodomy is a crime in Alabama.
What's that?
Mississippi. Sodomy is a punishable offense by prison.
Where's that at?
Like Alabama or Mississippi.
Well, yeah, of course, in the Bible, it's punishable by death. You know what I mean?
No, it's punishable. In the U.S., it's no law. They had that in the South.
Yeah.
Shit. It's still on the books. And they don't enforce it though.
Now faggots can get married.
What?
homosexuals, the man can marry a man.
That's weird shit.
That's weird shit.
And they get the same benefits. Actually, they get better benefits than a man and a woman's marriage. You know what I'm saying? Better benefits. This is crazy. So if you know them two faggots laying together, they're going to be producing a different disease every other day.
That's different because the Supreme Court, they're not saying it's right. It's just giving tax benefits for taxes. It's an economic situation.
A lot of them judges, they're all devil worshipers. Why else would they allow something like that? Think about it, bro. They all wearing, you ever see the Supreme Court?
It has to do with the Constitution.
But you ever see the Supreme Court building?
On the Constitution of the United States and freedom. It has to do with freedom.
But what is the Supreme Court building in Washington, D.C.? It's a giant temple.
It's a courthouse.
It's a temple.
So it's just
see that building right there? There's a temple right there. You see a giant temple? They call it the State House. Really a temple.
Yeah. It's our legislature. It's what legislature is at.
America is the reincarnation of the Roman Empire.
That's true.
Because they're really, they're priests of Baal.
I'm not cool about that.
So this was never a Christian nation, though. It was founded by Freemasons.
Yes, it is.
No, it was never founded by no Christian.
Look at the seal. In front of the courthouse, there's a seal on the ground.
Right.
And it says, walk over there and look at it.
Right.
I challenge
we got business. We did that over.
What's it say?
A bunch of bullshit.
God,
I wish I had the picture. Actually,
what
the picture.
God are they talking about?
Right.
It says the guy we trust.
The God with the Bible.
No. On the back of a dollar bill says the guy we trust.
God.
Right on the back of a dollar says the guy we trust.
God.
But, and it has an Egyptian pyramid.
It doesn't say God's S. God. One God.
What God is that, though?
There's one God. There's only one God. And one Lord. And one church.
Then why is there pagan symbolism on a dollar bill? With the Egyptian pyramid, the all-seeing eye of Ra, and then the eagle of Zeus.
Okay, that's America. America's all fucked up. But that doesn't negate the fact that there's
George Washington was a Freemason.
One Lord, one God.
You said America was founded by Christians.
No, I didn't say that.
Yeah, I hope not.
I'm not a pagan, and I don't believe you, bro. I know America is founded by Masons.
Yeah.
All that Mason shit on dollar bills, devil worship.
Yeah.
You know
that's what I'm
that
saying.
Shit. I know that shit too.
So I say this whole country's bullshit.
But that doesn't say that we are still not men of God. We're still men of God.
Not biblical.
Yeah, that's not biblical.
Freedom.
Freedom
is about freedom. If there wasn't freedom, there wouldn't be the United States.
There ain't no freedom, though.
Yes, there is.
When there was freedom, people were
enslaved. That's why people can be homosexuals.
Right, it's the freedom to do what the fuck you want.
Right. Basically, it's built on Lucifer.
Right.
I already know that shit. That's right. I believe that, too. I agree with you on that. We're down on that. This is like, the U.S. is like the nucleus.
It actually,
right here.
The Declaration of Independence said all men were created equal.
That's real shit.
And that's a lie.
What?
All men were created equal. We know that's not true.
This is an ideology.
That's a photo of the government right there.
That's an
see
ideology.
The photo?
Oh, yeah.
See the photo?
Yeah, that's a,
see all
that's a witchcraft.
Well, it's amazing.
They found, especially, I think it was Benjamin Franklin, they found bodies that were sacrificed in his house.
Underneath his house, buried. Like,
right, in his basement. In his basement. Because he had a big-ass crib. And he had, you know, some of these mansions. He got separations, got kitchens, and a whole separate living space. You know, the house was so big. They found hidden under the kitchen in the basement. The kitchen bodies that were sacrificed. Because the bodies show signs of being sacrificed. Like a knife slices or a nail hammered through heads and shit like that, man. Crazy. They did forensics on the shit, man.
Nah,
they were sacrifices.
They were pretty brutal. I'd never heard that before. It wouldn't surprise me, though.
Well, we're here to tell you the truth. We're here to give it to you. Bitches say, come at me 100.
It's not surprising. If it did happen, I wouldn't be like a surprise.
It still happened. You're elected officials.
Because this is not our kingdom. They want you to think it is, but you ain't got no part in this. This was not built for you.
Like you a vote, man.
Yeah, you do got a part in it. As in, that's
why we gotta pray, dude. That's why we gotta pray.
The slaves got a part on the plantation. They got a part, and it's the work from sun up to sundown. That's what we pray for.
So the thing.
Everybody's slaves in America.
Let's not have division, because Lucifer, his main stratagem is this: divide and conquer.
Divide and conquer. You're right.
So let's get unity.
And that's how everybody is divided.
That's right.
No, it's not.
That's why everybody is divided. You're right.
The world divides, and God unifies. Peace unifies. Love unifies. Love unifies. Yeah, John chapter 14.
Let's go to John 14.
About the unity of God.
And I'm going to show you
Gospel of John chapter 14.
Let's read it, bro. Hey, now this is Luke. This is red letters. We know what that means, right? Red letters, that's the one you call Jesus speaking, right? You believe that he was the Messiah, right? You believe that, right? Uh-oh, now you know.
I'm not saying anything.
Bro, watch what you're saying.
Go ahead. Suppose ye that I come to give peace on earth.
So the Lord said, do you suppose that I come to bring peace on earth? So do you think you came to bring peace?
Right.
He said he came to bring division. That's what the Lord said.
Now, you know the difference between right and wrong, don't you?
Yeah, do you?
The division is between right and wrong.
So what's right and what's wrong?
Don't take it out of context. You wanted to say that it's us against you.
Okay.
But it's not what it says.
Okay.
There's a difference between right and wrong. There's a difference between right and wrong.
From henceforth, there shall be five in one house divided, three against two, and two against three.
So specifying houses.
A father shall be divided against the son.
The son against the father.
And the son against the father, the mother against the daughter, and the daughter against the mother.
Damn.
The mother-in-law
against
the
son. You're going to use the word of my Lord Jesus Christ for Lucifer, bro. Because you mean to divide the unity of the mystical body of the Lord.
Oh, this is scripture that says divide. Divide. Divide.
Stick
it
with us, man.
No.
Stick
it
with
us.
Too late, bro. We don't see the truth.
Put
it in the context. Read the whole thing and put it in context.
We just did put it in context.
What was the context?
The Lord said he came to bring division.
That you mean to divide.
No, the Lord means to divide.
You tell me.
I got one.
Did you look up what I told you to look up? There's one Lord, one house of the Lord, one mystical body, one church, one. Unity. You mean to divide the unity. If you're a divider, you're not with us.
Why did the Lord say he came to bring, he going to divide?
Because you're ignorant, you don't understand scripture, because you don't read all of it.
Yeah, no,
this is Matthew 24:9. Then shall they deliver you.
Adios.
You didn't flick them, look up. And shall kill you.
Why don't you read what I told you to read? I told you what to read.
Well, don't go nowhere. I'm going to read. Let me go to it.
And you're not reading what I told you to read.
Bro, we try to read.
You're picking out little snippets. You're picking out snippets here and there. Trying to make making your own ideology out of it. It's negative shit, bro. The Lord God is one Lord, one God, one unity, one church, one spirit, one, and you're divided. You're the fighters, bro. So if you're the fighter, you're not part of us.
You said John 14, right? John 14. Hold up, man. Okay, this is why we go here and there and a little here and there. Okay, this is Isaiah 28:9.
Okay, where did the Lord Jesus Christ come here and hate people? This is hate. Listen,
love will conquer all. I agree.
This is hate. This is hate.
Facts are crucial.
Line upon line.
Got this shit.
Exactly. Here a little. And there a
Am
little.
I wrong?
The Lord said, "Love is not
logic,
the world."
These two You're things wrong. Together.
Exactly.
Love not the world.
This is hate.
Your heart.
Well, I mean, no, what we've been doing hasn't worked. We've been working with the judgment and fingers pointing back at us. So keep it simple. Love and logic will conquer all. I mean, really, keep it simple. You weren't there when the Bible was written.
Right. We was there.
Right,
we
exactly.
We were there.
What I can see from my face.
We were there.
And in front of me, I see righteous gentlemen.
We wrote the Bible.
Right.
Righteous gentlemen who are strong. Keep it up.
That
Be well.
Okay, so give hate love, to everybody. What's going to happen with the love?
Righteous gentlemen.
Well, I mean, let's see. What's the agenda here? To advance
like
the human race?
The world. Make love change the world.
My question here to you guys is, what's your agenda here? To become more conscious and to enlighten people?
That's what we're doing.
Yeah. I mean, some of this shit's right on. Some of it may not be. I agree with propaganda and the occultism of things and the Jews and all that. This shit makes perfect sense.
Do you believe the Lord hates?
Do I believe the Lord hates? If the Lord exists,
that's your idea. You don't know God.
Look, you gotta have
you
a balance.
You don't know God, bro.
Absolutely.
That ain't
balance. There's a time
that's
to kill.
Love.
Ecclesiastes says, there's a time for war, there's a time for
John
peace. There's a time for love, there's a time for hate. It's time. There's a time for everything.
Well, that's your view.
No, there's no
view. You're entitled to it.
There's balance. There's a time for everything. There's a time to laugh, there's a time to cry.
If I do a good deed, I'm not gonna go out and do a bad deed to balance stuff.
No.
Of course not.
But we're not doing bad deeds. We're telling people to abstain from
that. I just try to keep hate out of my system and try to focus on positive things. Become more conscious of myself and my surroundings. And how can you go wrong with that?
But so you tell me you hate
good. It's funny. I love love and I hate hate.
It's
a way to make one think, you know? And it's pretty funny. But really, though,
it's a paradox.
We got to keep it simple. Keeping it simple is the best way, to go about it.
The scriptures say that there's a simplicity.
That's wonderful.
It's a simplicity.
Some people choose Buddhism, some people choose nothing, some people choose Islam. As long as you're trying to advance yourself, your family, the human race, I'm going to be honest.
We've been thinking about trying to do that.
No, it separates.
Hey, they've been thinking that same situation for 100 years. Nothing changed.
We out here revealing mysteries, all right, at the end of the day.
We out here.
Yeah, we out here. Lord, we revealing mysteries.
Right. Well, I do the same thing as like a sovereign, a patriot.
You know,
like,
I'm speaking.
Yeah, I think it's important. Education is crucial, of course. It's about a message and how we get across. What's our attempt? What's our agenda? To unify, to enlighten, to get people to believe your way. It's not going to come with knocking heads, that's for sure. That guy's a little extreme, but you know, I get where he's coming from. But he may be right, you may be right, you both may be wrong. You don't know.
Right.
We don't know. We're finding out new things all the time. We'd be kind of arrogant to figure out we know this for sure. We might not even stand it on the real. It might be
illusion. But we do know that.
Well, it might be.
I definitely know that this panel.
Yeah, those guys. We appreciate you for bringing the real stuff out. Absolutely.
That's hatred, bro. You must be an anti-Semite.
Well, no. I look at hatred, bro.
That's hatred. Stop being hateful.
Don't tell me how I feel and what I'm exuding. I appreciate you, brother.
Yeah.
Every time you got a finger point, you get a 3-point right back. I remember hearing that a while ago. It makes sense. Oh, how you doing, Mama? Good to see you. But you guys keep it up, man. I love you very much. Be well. Yep.
Ecclesiastes 3:7. A time to rend, a time to sow, a time to teach science, and a time to speak.
It's a scripture for all these people talking about love. All right, there's more to life than just love. Okay. There's a lot of other shit going on. All right.
Time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace.
So there's a time for everything. There's a time to love somebody. There's a time to hate the shit out of somebody too. There's a time for peace and happiness, and there's a time for death and destruction.
That's right, and that's the time we're in, time for death and destruction.
There's a time to be joyful and a time to mourn. This is common sense.
Right.
But I guess sense ain't common, you know what I mean?
Right. Man, we in a time of war. We're in a time to break down.
Yeah.
You know, the time of when you turn them plowshares into pruning hooks.
Are you guys familiar with sovereignty and the power of the word, where it comes from, and where it lies?
Sovereignty,
yeah.
There's only one sovereign. It's the Most High.
Well, right. Most High, supreme dominion. In this physical sense, means control of property.
Right.
It means legitimacy in the government.
Well, in this world, sovereignty comes from your army.
You feel that way?
Well,
it comes from within, individually. There's an individual and collective sovereignty.
Well, I'm talking about this physical world, this political system. We're dealing with, you're not sovereign unless you got an army to back you up.
Are you familiar with the polar shifts and the spiritual center of the world shifts in about 13,000 years, pursuant to certain research?
Yeah,
and we're about on that tip. I think we're going to get past the simplicity.
Well, we're coming into a new age of
the
light shift.
Yes, sir.
Era.
I would like to hear.
A new era.
I would like to hear what you got to say.
It's about coming.
Actually, it's a new eon.
Jeremiah 1:9.
Yeah, that's the word.
Then Yahweh put forth his hand and touched my mouth, and Yahweh, for the Most High's name, said unto me, Behold, I put my words into thy mouth. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms.